even, yeah.
Wasn't it that garden scene? Yeah. He had a trouble coming.
Even I was like, come on, guys.
So when you guys were like all attacking me at once?
Yeah.
It was bad. But you know, I say that as well. Like, we get asked all the time, and usually it comes along with, like, how do those guys ever get anything done? You do, they're professionals, and obviously the show hasn't lasted because they're, you know, goofy and ridiculous, but they're really good at their job. And, for example, I was there, that scene that we shot in the hotel room, I was shadowing Phil in this episode, and had to light the Bible on fire. So you have, like, one prop, and it's a bit clunky because it's wired to be lit, and you don't want to do it a bunch of times. So it gets lit, and it has to go in the bin, and Jensen's holding the trash can, and it goes in, and his hand is almost catching fire, but it's a really serious moment, and he knows it's going to take us, like, 45 minutes to reset if we cut. But my hand's kind of burning. But he dumped the water, such a pro, got the shot, but Jared lost it because he was laughing at the ridiculousness of the situation. And Phil was behind the camera, and he's like, oh God, I lost them. It's over. The night's over. We're never going to get it back. But they got the shot. So yeah, that's where they're brilliant.
The pranks are always well timed. And the tank, I don't know.
The tanks are full of
this one time, Jensen played this prank on me because we were in the scene where we were just supposed to be talking, and then he kissed me, like, out of the blue, and I was not expecting it.
Throw some shit at her.
No, I'm kidding. Oh, I'm talking about the only kiss scene that was in the script.
Kind of makes me want to kiss you.
That's always weird, though, too, because I get asked a lot. I had to, like, seduce Jensen, and everyone's like, was that amazing? And I'm like, no. There was 200 men standing behind him when I was talking about dripping blood on his chin. It's weird. So we're literally walking the set, and I'm like, so how's the baby? How's life? Hey, I'm gonna talk really dirty to you. I'm so sorry. It's weird. Kissing scenes are always weird. Like, you're at work. Picture this. Picture your workplace. You're on break. You're hanging out, water cooler, break room. How are your kids? How's your family? You go see the concert that weekend? You two kiss. It's fucking weird.
No. You. I need your nose out of the way. Us saliva. And action. Okay. All right. Let's talk.
Why is there red lipstick all over his mouth?
Makeup. We gotta get some nose hairs. That was me.
In my case with Rob, give me your lip. I'm supposed to be fighting it.
We had a demo at our PJ party of the kiss between Rob and Kim.
Okay, I'll lead you into it. I don't know how we got here from there, but I'm willing to happily go for it. So I was supposed to pull his lip, I was supposed to bite his bottom lip and pull it out. And I wanted to know how hard to do this.
Everybody seen this scene?
I heard it. Came from Supernatural for a brief moment. And so I was like, Rob, can we at least try it once before we're rolling so I know how hard to bite you and it don't hurt you? And he's like, yeah, okay. So I'm Rob and she's me. And this is what he did.
Pull focus marks, so literally it was a point where you're kissing, and you're like, can we see the kiss? And you're like, you have to stand there like this. Take like 4 minutes.
How long did it take, Emily?
What? How long did it take? What do you mean?
For them to...
That was such an impressive statement.
How long did it take, Emily?
I don't know!
Remember it.
I will say this.
Different angles.
The really nice thing about it is that, and this is when I do think it actually works out looking the best, because there's this idea that, like, it's only going to look really good if, like, you really feel it, but it's just weird. And so the thing that I really appreciated about that episode is that Jensen and I were able to talk with, I don't remember who was directing, I think it might have been Phil, and ask, like, what is the style of this kiss? Because there's so many different things that you can communicate with a kiss. And this was, you know, this was your standard, I'm about to suck your soul, oh no, wait, let me kiss you kiss, which we've all had.
Yeah, that's know, as you do.
Yeah. And so that for me is so comforting, because otherwise, like, I'm in it and I'm wondering, like, does this look the way they want it to look? Like, I've always felt the most comfortable and trusted that it's going to look the sexiest or the most loving or whatever in scenes where, like, you get to talk about what is the story we're telling with this kiss or with this makeout scene or whatever. And you kind of, like, it's almost like a dance. You choreograph in your mind, like, what the different marks you need to hit are. And then you do it.
And we text you afterwards to ask how it was.
Oh, yeah. I was supposed to, like, give a numerical rating.
We'll never tell.
Secrets. Secret.
Is
that bad? Thank you for your question.
Thank you.
What was the question?
It's about Price.
Okay, Price. It always comes back to kissing Jared or Jensen, I think, probably. I feel like every question.
Hey, yeah. Does everyone else have the same thing when they started watching the show? Where you just watch it for ages trying to work out who's the most attractive? Is that what everyone does? That's all. It's just me.
What's difficult is when someone's talking to you and you're like, or they say, oh, okay, Dean, is that the attractive one?
I know, like, what question is
that?
Yeah. Like, they're both gorgeous.
Well, then what's the other one? Also incredibly attractive. What's your point?
Well, and I like when people ask, like, who's your... I'm like, why pick?
No. Like, working with both of them is like looking into the sun.
I think the sun's actually behind their head and you have to look out.
Also, the visual tunnel.
For me, I see the ground.
Yeah, no, I see the sun. Even shines out their asses. I think somebody else must have a question. Stop me.
Hi there.
Stop me.
Hi, my name is Alyssa. First of all, I just wanted to say that I really love you guys for helping so many people, like, love themselves a little more. Like, you helped me love my piercing and my tattoo and my weight and how I act. And I just love you guys a lot.
Thank you. Thank you.
My question is, if you guys were in charge of, like, the costume department, what would you make each other and the boys wear?
Huh. Nothing.
I second that.
It's so early.
I once had a pair of, what are they called? Agent Provocateur, fluffy. High heels, I make everybody wear them, especially Jared.
His calves look amazing.
Yeah, he's got the best calves. But yeah, I think those little saddles, those little mules would be awesome in all of us.
And only.
That's all.
Fair enough. Simple answer.
Yeah.
I think I would put everybody kind of in costumes that are the opposite of what their character wears.
Like, they'd have to take a coat off? Everyone has a coat on that show all the time.
Not me!
It's cold, Tina!
I know! Sweet.
I needed a coat! You guys, do you know how proud genuinely I was of Jensen watching him in scenes with her? I was like, he is training his eyes so well right now. Genuine, I was like, I am so proud of my friend.
Amara did not have a lot of time to choose her wardrobe. She had things to get done.
Although Ruth and I used to say that we really wanted Rowena to take Amara on a shopping trip.
Yeah, I think Rowena, it would be cool if she could glamour everyone and everyone could have a gown and sparkly eyeshadow.
I like that idea.
I like it too.
I think it's Rowena. I think it's
not because they're not people, just because Donna would be hilarious sitting there like, what do I do with this?
Oh, jeez.
We have one more.
We've answered three questions.
Good question.
Oh, I'm a survivor.
That one. You just sounded like straight up country.
Yeah.
I'm a survivor.
That was Richard Spain singing
Survivor. I have so many people have suggested songs to me for The Darkness.
Yeah, me too. I get something like Bish.
Hello, Darkness. Is there a song called Bish?
Yeah, I would have to say The Sound of Silence because so many people have posted on my Twitter feed with that. Hello, Darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again. It's a small world after all. It's a small world. Just to like catch everyone by surprise.
Yeah, see, I was thinking Jody would sing Barbie Girl by Aqua. Just to fuck with people.
I think Donna would sing like something really on like Florence and the Machine or something.
Yeah.
Like. And she would just like headbang in her living room. Giving it.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen.